This video is on percentages and percentile. We are familiar with percentages as kids in our school. Later, we learn to communicate percentages in the marketplace. Later, some of us who make their way into the corporate world use this for effective communication and comparison. Finally, statistics from a small market study to planning the nation uses percentages. And to know more about percentile, we need to study about percentages in detail. Presently, we are giving you one keyword to ponder on: competitiveness. A percentage B is a formal method of representing, comparing, and communicating between two quantities of the same physical type. Though it is derived from fractions to start with. Fractions are numbers in the rational number set which can be used to represent, compare, and communicate quantities of the same physical type, A by B. That is, for every B, there is A quantities in a system. Next, ratios. They are a better way of expressing quantities and comparing them. They are also derived from fractions. Here, A by B becomes A is to B. Now, percentages are the most polished way to study and present two quantities of the same physical type and is highly used in presentations in the corporate world. Finally, percentiles are percentages in itself and will be dealt through the video. Now, we highly recommend you watch our video on ratios, ratio, proportion, and variation. Also, our video on different types of numbers discussed in Story of Numbers, how to understand a number better discussed in Factorization of a Number, and finally Basics of Arithmetic in Introduction to Arithmetic. For this, you can either search for MathPinnacle on YouTube or visit our Facebook page, facebook.com/MathPinnacle. Fractions and ratios. As shown in the figure, the physical measure of A and B of the same type are small letter A and B. Mathematically, A by B can be represented as a fraction small a by small b, and we can understand that for every B quantities, there is A quantities. Now, commonly, it is also represented in the form of ratios as A is to B, which still say that for every B quantities, there is A quantities. Now, you can convert the ratio back into fractions for problem solving in mathematics. Ratios and percentages. Now, as shown in the figure, the physical measure of quantities A and B, caps lock, is A and B in the lowercase. Now, ratio of A is to B is equal to small a is to small b, which is equivalent to A by B mathematically, both again in the lowercase. Now, A by B in the uppercase equal to A by B in the lowercase. Now, let us have A by 1b, and the RHS would give A by B in the numerator and 1 in the denominator. Now, multiply both numerator and denominator by 100. So, we get in the LHS A by 100B uppercase equal to A by B into 100 in the numerator and 100 in the denominator. Now, A percentage B is basically how many A's you have in 100B. That is, per gives you every and cent is for 100. So, for every 100B, you have A which is equal to A by B into 100. Hence, A percentage B equal to A by B into 100. A and B in the lower case. Ratios to percentage. Here we have three typical types of ratios. Type 1. A is to B when expressed as percentage becomes A by B into 100. Type 2. A minus B is to B, when expressed as percentage becomes A minus B divided by B into 100. Common application being profit percentage. Type 3. B minus A is to B when expressed as percentage becomes B minus A divided by B into 100. Common application being to calculate loss percentage. Example for ratios to percentage. In this example, now a merchant sells one product at cost price of rupees 100 at a selling price of rupees 130 and another product of cost price of rupees 100 at rupees 90 selling price to a customer. What is the profit loss percentage in each case and also the total profit or loss percentage? Now, profit percentage of A equal to 30%. Since the profit expressed in terms of cost price which is equal to 100 gives you 30. Hope you are able to identify that. Similarly for B, the loss percentage is 10%. And finally we see that the total selling price is more than the total cost price by rupees 20. And when it is expressed as a percentage to the total cost price 200, we get an overall profit percentage of 10%. Percentages to fractions. Percentages are converted to its mathematical equivalent fractions for problem solving. Now here we have the corresponding three types which we discussed in ratios to percentages. Now, if A and B are physical quantities and small a and small b are its measures, if A percentage B is x percent, then small a by small b equal to x by 100. That is type 1. Type 2, if A more than B percentage B equal to x percent, that gives you A by B in the lower case equal to 1 plus x by 100. Similarly for type 3, if A less than B percent to B percent equal to x percent, this converts to A by B in the lower case to 1 minus x by 100. Example for percentage to ratio. Now, here, a product A of cost price 1000 is sold at a profit percentage of 10% and another product B, cost price of rupees 100, is sold at a loss percentage of 10%. We need to calculate the total loss or profit percentage. Now, for this, we need to find the total selling price. The total cost price is given as 1100. Selling price of A, SPA, is equal to 1 plus 10 by 100 into 1000, which is equal to 1100. Now, selling price of B is equal to 1 minus 10 by 100 into 100, which is equal to 90. Now, here we see that the total selling price is rupees 1190. Now, the total profit is equal to 90. And when that is expressed in terms of the total cost price, you get the total profit percentage equal to 8.1%. Application of percentages. Growth. Growth of an entity A to A1 is similar to profit percentage when A is sold at A1. Hence, A1 equal to A into 1 plus G1 by 100, where G1 is the growth percentages, which is similar to profit percentage in the first time period of sequence. Now, A2, the growth from A1 at a growth percentage of G2 at the second sequence, we get A2 equal to A1 into 1 plus G2 by 100. Now substituting for A1, we get A2 equal to A into 1 plus G1 by 100 close bracket, 1 plus G2 by 100 close bracket. And the general formula for growth over time or sequences is An equal to A into 1 plus G1 by 100 into 1 plus G2 by 100 and finally 1 plus Gn by 100. Now an example for successive growth. Here a person invests rupees 10,000 in a business and earns a growth of 10%, 15% and 20% over the first 3 years. Now to calculate the final amount due to him, which is equal to the initial amount A multiplied by 1 plus G1 by 100 into 1 plus G2 by 100 into 1 plus G3 by 100. Here, G1 equal to 10%, G2 equal to 15%, and G3 equal to 20%. And finally, AF is equal to 10,000 into 1.1 into 1.15 into 1.2. Note that it is smart to get the factors 1.1, 1.15, and 1.2 directly when you are given the growth of 10%, 15%. And 20%. Now depreciation or discount over time periods or steps or sequences or events. This is also an application of percentages. Here depreciation is similar to loss percentage when an entity changes from a value of A to less A1. When loss percentage is given as D1, we get A1 equal to 1 minus D1 by 100 into A. Now the same applies to depreciation. If A depreciates to A1 by D1%, we get A1 equal to 1 minus D1 by 100 into A. Now if A1 again depreciates to A2, we get A2 equal to A1 into 1 minus D2 by 100. Now substituting for A1, we get A2 equal to A into 1 minus D1 by 100 into 1 minus D2 by 100. And in general terms, An equal to A into 1 minus D1 by 100 into 1 minus D2 by 100 and finally 1 minus Dn by 100. Example for successive depreciation. Here the value of a car depreciates from 10 lakhs over the next 3 years at a depreciation rates of D1%, D2% and D3%. Now the initial value of the automobile being 10 lakhs is multiplied with 1 minus D1 by 100 into 1 minus D2 by 100 into 1 minus D3 by 100. And we get 10 lakh into 0.8 into 0.85 into 0.90. And the final value becomes 6,12,000. If you are smart, you would have arrived at the final factors 0.8, 0.85 and 0.9 immediately when you got the depreciation rates of 20%, 15% and 10% respectively. This concept is applicable to profit percentage and loss percentage. If the quantity is sold at 10% profit from X, the selling price would be X into 1.1. And if it is sold at 10% loss from Y, the selling price would be Y into 0.9. Percentages and percentile. Let's first compare between the basics of percentage and percentile. Percentage is based on marks obtained in an examination, and percentile is based on the rank obtained in an examination. Percentages are relative to the standard of the examination, and percentile is relative to the other candidates appearing in the examination. Finally, it is not possible to compare the percentage of two candidates who scored over the two different years, though percentile and rank can give a good idea of how two candidates scored at 2 years in a particular society. Example, 20 years back, someone getting 90% in the 10th grade boards would be topper in his class, but today 95 plus is very common. But someone who scored a rank of less than 1000 in an engineering entrance examination can be said to have performed almost similar to someone who had scored last year around. Though some factors are not considered, example competitiveness towards education. But though over the last 20 years, it is moreover the same. Here we compare how to calculate percentage and percentile. For percentage, if A got a mark of X out of a total of Y, the percentage marks scored by A to total marks is equal to X by Y into 100. Now if A wrote an exam and got a rank of small n out of capital N candidates appear, you have to first calculate how many candidates are below him, that is n dash equal to capital N minus small n. Now the percentile of n is equal to small n dash by capital N into 100. Now take time to read the question. Okay, here S gets a mark of 580 out of 600 in the board exam and a rank of 150 in the entrance exam. And hence S got a percentage of 96.6% in the board exam and a percentile of 98.5 in the entrance exam. Now R gets a percentage of 91.6% in the board exam and a percentile of 99.1 in the entrance exam. So let's see who qualifies for which college. Now, according to the information provided, S qualifies for the first college A since the cutoff was 95% and he obtained 96.6% and does not qualify for the second college B, which had a cutoff of 99% and he failed by 0.5%. R does not qualify for the first college A as he does not clear the cutoff of 95% in his board exam, though he gets 99.1% for the entrance exam and hence qualifies for the second college B.